Welcome to Season 20 of Classical Music Discoveries. This is your hostess, Sandy Hedgecock. Thank you for joining our happy listeners throughout the world. For complete information on how to submit your music for airplay, to advertise on our show, or to visit our online music store, please visit our auxiliary website at classicalmusicdiscoveries.store for complete information. Please don't forget to like the broadcast you're listening to so the composers and musicians know you like their musical contribution.
Looking to get somewhere but don't have a way to get there? Maybe your car is in the shop, or maybe you just don't want to deal with parking fees or traffic. Just use the Uber app to order a ride and let our friendly drivers take the hassle out of your drive. So just relax and let us do the driving for you. Uber is a proud sponsor of Classical Music Discoveries.
Haydn's Symphony No. 31 in D major was composed in 1765 for his patron Nicholas Esterházy. It is nicknamed the Hornsignal Symphony because it gives a very prominent role to an unusually large horn section, which at the time was four horn players. Probably because of its prominent obbligato writing for the horns, in Paris, the publisher Sieber published the symphony as a symphony concertante for horn around 1785.
Thank you.
Symphony No. 32 in C major is a festive symphony by Haydn. The exact date of composition is unknown. It has been suggested by noted Haydn scholar Robbins Landon that it could have been composed as early as 1757 and as late as 1763, so he's not even sure. More recent scholars have suggested it was composed either in 1760 or 1761. This is a four-movement work, and it's scored for two oboes, bassoon, two horns, two trumpets, timpani, strings, and continuo.
Thank you. Thank you.
Symphony No. 3 is another festive symphony by Haydn. The precise date of composition is unknown. Haydn scholar Robbins Landon has dated this work from 1763 to 65. It has also been suggested that it was composed in 1760 or 1761, along with Symphony No. 32. So again, nobody really knows when this was composed. The symphony is scored for two oboes, bassoon, two horns, two trumpets, timpani, strings, and continuo. Although Haydn's original timpani part was lost, Robbins Landon has reconstructed it. There are four movements to this work. Thank you.
Thank you.
Symphony No. 34 in D minor by Haydn, according to traditional chronology, was composed in 1765, shortly before Haydn's Sturm und Drang period in 1766, during his social withdrawal at Erzherzogstift. However, more recent chronologies place it 2 years earlier in 1763, which, if correct, would suggest that it is the first minor key symphony Haydn ever composed, though there is some uncertainty around the chronology, with Symphony No. 26 being the traditional candidate for the first minor symphony, and Symphony No. 39 is also another candidate as the first minor symphony composed by Haydn.
Thank you. Thank you.
Symphony number 35 in B major, the autograph page is carefully dated December 10th, 1767. It has been speculated that this symphony was composed to celebrate Prince Esterházy's return from a visit to the Palace of Versailles. The symphony is scored for two oboes, bassoon, two horns, strings, and continuo. The horns are given plenty of terrifying, difficult parts. It is in four movements. Thank you.
This broadcast is copyrighted by Classical Music Discoveries. Any reproduction of this show without the express written permission of Classical Music Discoveries is strictly prohibited. You may request authorization by emailing us at ken@classicalmusicdiscoveries.com.
Thank you for listening to Classical Music Discoveries. We hope you have enjoyed this broadcast. To purchase this album, please visit classicalmusicdiscoveries.store. You can also advertise on our show, donate to our Women in Classical Music program, or learn more about us also at classicalmusicdiscoveries.store. Again, thank you for listening, and until next time, happy listening.